Page 111. Notes for the teacher. Units 8 to 10. A short monsoon diary. Some extracts from the diary of a nature lover who enjoys the monsoon in the hills and observes the accompanying changes in the world of flora and fauna. Activities under working with language are numerous and of different types. Spend sufficient time on each activity and devise, wherever necessary, new but related exercises for further practice. The following project may be tried under writing. Do you notice the changes that occur in nature as the seasons change? Write 5 or 6 sentences about what you see in nature in your part of the country during the months of May, August, and December. Record the daily temperature for a fortnight and note down the maximum and minimum temperatures. Comment on the rise and fall in temperature. Record the time of sunrise and sunset for a fortnight and check if there is any appreciable change in the time. On the grasshopper and cricket. This poem is relatively difficult. The difficulty lies in its brevity of expression and complexity of thought. The introductory note and activities under working with a poem should be done elaborately, adding additional explanatory notes, tasks, wherever necessary. Compare it with the ant and the cricket to bring out differences of style and theme clearly with examples. To concretize the poetry of earth or the sounds of nature, use the poem given below, which is all about animal cries. Page 112. Ask children to rearrange the lines, taking note of the words that rhyme. The last line of each stanza begins with but. Cows moo, lions roar, but I speak. Bears snore, doves coo, crickets creak. Dogs growl, horses neigh, but I talk. Wolves howl, donkeys bray, parrots squawk. The Great Stone Face, first and second. A classic piece of American fiction juxtaposing mellowness of humanism with magnificence of art. Ernest, an unschooled dweller of the valley, has close affinity with the stone face atop the hills beyond. Who resembles the splendid stone face? Not someone for all his wealth, not someone else for all his heroic deeds, and not someone else yet again for his poetry and sublime ideas. It is none other than Ernest who personifies a rare blend of basic simplicity, practical wisdom, and deep love for humanity. The original story has been heavily abridged. Simplification has been avoided in the interest of authenticity. You may like to read the unabridged text for pleasure and edification. Design 3 or 4 while reading comprehension questions for each section of the text, parts 1st and 2nd. The writing activity, part 2nd to 4th, is for further practice in language analysis. Rearranging phrases to construct sentences and then rearranging sentences to construct a paragraph will provide many opportunities for thinking about cohesion and coherence. Activities 1 and 2 under Working with Language, Part 1st, on adding ness and itty, for forming nouns and adding ly to adjectives for forming adverbs, should be completed in 3 or 4 sessions. One period may be devoted to each item, including resolving intermittent queries and offering explanations and the writing work involved.
Honeydew, you were just listening to this audiobook. Production assistants Meenakshi Kugreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Buttilang Lingdo. Technical assistance, Vikas Sangwan and Soumya Malik. Produced by Ajit Horo and presented to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.